Hello friends, my name is Ajinkya and I am the Microsoft Python Certified Trainer. In the last video session, we saw that how we can insert a data into an Excel file. So in this video tutorial, we will see how we can create a registration form and insert a value into our database. So for this purpose, I am creating a form that is a let's run the project. I will explain the code. So this is our registration form. Okay, so user fill the information. Suppose enter the name, enter the gender, email and mobile number. When the user click on the insert button, the data will transfer to the database. So how we can achieve this task? Let's see in the practically. So for this purpose, I am creating. First, I am import these modules. That is a TK inter module. To connect with MySQL, so there is a by MySQL, and to show the messages to the user, we will use a message box module. So this code is used for to connect to the database. So in the previous video session, we saw that how we can configure a database. So in this way, you can configure the database. So MySQL, that is a duplicate name given to the MySQL, that is a MySQL dot connect method. So connect method requires the first parameter, that is a server name, username, password, then database name. So this is our database name, that is a Python registration. So first I am giving the title, that is a student registration, then maintain the height and width by using the geometry method and resizable the window. Don't resize. That is, we avoid the resize of the window by using the resizable, that is 00. So first we create a heading label, that is a heading label. So this is a heading, student registration detail. So heading label, so this is a heading label, which is present at row 0, column 1. Then we will create a name. Enter the name, then it entry, that is a name entry. So in the same way, we have to create a gender label, that is a enter the gender, then entry, gender entry. Then we create a email entry. This is a mobile label, that is a enter the mobile number and the mobile entry. So in this way, we create a registration form. So this is a button. The button name, I will provide the insert button. This is a button name. So in this way, I am creating a registration form. So this is a registration form. So whenever user click on the insert button, the data transfer to the database. Okay. So before this, I am using the PHP MyAdmin, and in the PHP MyAdmin, we already created a Python registration database, and in the Python registration database, I am creating a student info. So this is a table. That is a student info table. So in the student info table, the field should be like this. That is a ID. It is a adult incremented. Student name, student gender, email. And student mobile number. Okay, so these are the field I already created the table, that is a studinfo. So let's see practically how we can insert a data into a database. So for this purpose, first you configure the database like this. So db is the object. Cursor can be used, or cursor class can be used to execute the SQL statement. So for this purpose, I am creating one method called as insert data. This is my method name. So in the insert data, I am using the try and accept block. So this is I am using the try and accept block. So first you need to insert. You need to write a query like or take the data from the entry. So for this purpose, first I am giving a data from entry visit. So how we can giving the data from entry visit? So first my entry visit name is a name entry. Okay, so I am creating a variable name as a name is equal to name entry dot get value. Okay, so next gender. So I am creating a variable called a gender. So gender entry dot get. In the same way, the next that is a email. So I am creating the variable name as email. So email entry dot, there is a method called get method, and last that is a mobile. So this is a mobile entry dot get method. So in this way you can get the values from the entry visit. So this is our entry visit, that is so I am removing this and let's run the project. So this is our entry, that is name entry, gender entry, email entry and mobile entry. So this is our entry and we will get the value from this entry and save in these particular variables. So these are the variables in which the values are stored. So next step, using the try statement. So next step is that cursor dot object, that is a cursor dot, there is a method called execute method, and in the execute method we will write in the triple quotation mark a query, that is a insert into what is my table name, that is a, my table name is a stud info. So this is my table name stud info, insert into a stud info. So what are the my values, that is a s name comma. So this is my table, and in the table these are the field s gender, next field that is s gender, then next field email and s mobile. So these are the my field email and s mobile. So these are my field, and what are my values? So I am providing so these types of value in this way, percentage s for s name, same percentage s again for the gender, next percentage s, so this is a percentage s for the email, and last one that is a percentage s for the mobile number. So last, so in this way you can insert a data into a database. So first, my first parameter, that is we use here s name. So s name is present here, s name. So name, this is a variable name, and pass here, that is a name, next that is a gender, then next email, and last one is that, that is a mobile. So these are the field which is coming from, these are the field which is coming from this field, that is a name, gender, email and mobile. So whenever the, so in this way you create a query, that is execute cursor dot execute, whenever the user click on the insert button and data transfer to the database and show the message to the user, that is data inserted. So how we can show the message, that is a message box dot show info, this is a method. So first parameter, it required the name on the message, that is insert, and second parameter the text, that is data inserted. So this is a message to show to the user. So next db dot save the data by using the commit method, and last that is a db dot close the database connection. So in this way you create a registration form and to transfer a data from Python form to database. So in this way you have to create, and in the except block there print error. So error whenever the database connection fail, it shows the message that is an error message to the user. So in this way, you have to write a query or you have to write a method to insert a data into a database. So bind this method with a button. So how we can bind this method? This is our button, and in the button has a one property that is a command property. So command property, it requires the name of the method. So this is insert data, this is my method name or function name. So in this way, you write a code to insert a data into a database in the Python. So this is a very simple code. Let's run the application. So first my name, that is adjective, gender, that is a male. So this is a simple email ID, and this is my mobile number. So whenever the user click on the insert button, the message that is the data inserted. Okay, so go to the database and refresh. So this is my name, that is Ajinkya Mail, and this is my mail, this is mobile number. So in this way, you can write a code to insert into a database. Okay, so these are the entry, and we bind this name to this query, that is a gender, email, and mobile numbers. Okay, so this is the entry name, that is a name entry, gender, email, and mobile entry. These are the entry name. And whenever the user fills the entry, and that entry or that information placed in these variables. So in this way, you can bind or you can send a data from Python form to database. So in the last video also, we have to create a login session. Barabar? Okay. So let's run the project. That is a complete project. I'm run the login form. So my login username is admin and my password is also admin. Whenever the username and password are correct, it shows me a registration form. So this is my registration form. And user, whenever the fill the information, it goes to the database. So this is a complete application. First we create a login application. Whenever the username and password are correct, then it will display a student registration form to me. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. I hope you like this video. If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe my channel. In the next video, we will see how we can validate these fields or entry fields. Okay, so how we can clear entry visit, how we can validate, how we can check if entry are empty or not. So in this way, we will see all these in the next video practically. Thank you for watching this video.